Hi friends, welcome back to Angular Hero to Superhero series. If you are a beginner trying to learn Angular, there is another series, Angular 0 to Hero, in which I have explained all the basic concepts. You can find the link in the description. In this Angular series, Hero to Superhero, I am focusing on advanced concepts. In this video, I am going to explain about dependency providers. In Angular, dependency providers play a crucial role in the dependency injection. A dependency provider is a configuration that tells the Angular dependency injection system how to create and provide instances of certain objects such as services, components, and other parts of your application. In other words, the dependency provider is an instruction that describes how an object for a certain token is created. The Angular providers is an array of such instructions. Each provider is uniquely identified by a token in the provider's array, also known as dependency injection token. We can register the dependency in the provider's metadata in two ways. Either we can directly register in the provider's array of the ng module or component or in directive. Or we can use the provided in property of the @injectable decorator. The Angular components or services declare the dependencies they need in their constructor. The injector reads the dependencies and looks for the provider in the provider's array using the token. It then instantiates the dependency using the instructions provided by the provider. The injector then injects the instance of the dependency into the components or services. To provide an instance of the dependency, we need to register it in the provider's metadata. We can do it like this. Ideally, this is the short form of this. Here we have provide and a provider. Provide holds the dependency injection token, which is used to locate the provider in the provider's array. The token can be either a type, a string, or an instance of injection token. Provider tells Angular how to create the instance of the dependency. The Angular can create the instance of the dependency in four different ways: useClass, useExisting, useValue, and useFactory. I am going to explain each one of them using a simple example. In this application, I have created two services: an authentication service in which I have a function which prints this message in the console, and another fake authentication service in which I have a function which prints another message. In the onInit of the app component, I'm just calling the function from the service. As we have provided the real authentication service in the module, we can see this message. Assume that you need to use a fake authentication service in case of testing. Then you can use the use class to inform Angular to use the fake authentication service class, like this. Now you can see the implementation has been changed. Okay, let me explain use existing. I have changed the code slightly. I have introduced a header component in which I have a button to log in and log out. On clicking these buttons, I am going to change the logged in status in the authentication service. My expectation is that when I click this login button, the authentication status will be set to true. And when I click this button, I can print that. Subsequently, when I click the logout button, it will be set to false. But for some reason, I need to use a fake authentication service in my header, but I need to implement the functionality from authentication service in the app component. And so, in app module, I am going to use two different injection tokens with the same authentication service as useClass. Now if I test it, it will not work. That is because, as we are using two different injection tokens, two instances of the service class will be created. So, ideally, we are setting it in one instance and trying to get it from another instance, which will not work. In this scenario, we can use useExisting. The useExisting provider configuration is used to indicate that a new token should be mapped to an existing token, so that when a component or service requests a dependency, it receives the instance provided by the original token. Now we can see it is working again. By using useExisting, we avoid duplicating instances and ensure that components receive the correct instance of the shared service based on the aliased tokens. Okay, next one is useValue. The useValue provider configuration is used to provide a constant value as a dependency. This means when a component or service requests a dependency using a certain token, the value associated with that token is directly returned as the dependency, without any instantiation or modification. The useValue configuration is often used when you want to provide configuration settings, constants, or simple objects as dependencies to your components and services. Let me explain this using an example. I have created a configuration object in which I have some configurations. I have frozen the object so that changes are not allowed. Now let me provide this. I am going to use the useValue. Like this. Now in app component, I can inject this. And so I can access the configuration object. By using useValue, you provide a static value directly to your components and services without the need for a factory or constructor to create instances. This is particularly useful for providing global settings or constants throughout your application. But please note that using string tokens can be error prone. And in modern Angular applications, it is recommended to use injection tokens for better type safety and maintainability. So to convert the string token to injection token, first we need to import the injection token from Angular core. And then we can create a new injection token like this. Now we need to provide this token instead of string token. And in app component, now we can use the new injection token. Like this. Okay, the last one is useFactory. The useFactory provider configuration is used to create and provide instances of dependencies using a factory function. This allows you to have more control over the instantiation and configuration of a dependency before it's injected into the consuming component or service. The useFactory configuration is particularly useful when you need to perform custom logic, set up configurations, or perform additional operations while creating instances of a dependency. We usually use the useFactory when we want to return an object based on a certain condition. Let me explain this using an example. Assume we want to inject either the authentication service or the fake authentication service based on a flag. We can achieve this use case using a useFactory and useValue. First, let me create a new token using useValue. And then, while providing the authentication service, instead of useClass or useExisting, let me use useFactory. This accepts a function to which I can pass a parameter. Based on this parameter, I can return the instance of the authentication service or the fake authentication service. I can pass this parameter through the dependencies array. Now, if I run the application, we can see it is using the authentication service. If I change this to true, we can see it is using the fake authentication service. We can also move this logic to a function and call that function here, like this. useFactory provides us a flexible way to create and customize instances of dependencies, allowing us to perform additional logic or customization during their creation. Hope you understood. That's all for today. Please like this video, subscribe to my channel, and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.